On the 13th of October 1944, two German generals visited a famous colleague, a field marshal and decorated war hero, at his family home. He left with them, and 15 minutes later he was dead by suicide at the age of 52. This is the story of Field Marshal Erwin Rommel. The son of a schoolteacher, Erwin Rommel was born on the 15th of November 1891, near Ulm in the German state of Württemberg. The Rommel family typified the worthy middle-class world of provincial Germany, and their son dutifully joined the army in July 1910. Rommel started as an officer cadet, but was quickly promoted to corporal and then sergeant. Whilst attending military school in Danzig, Rommel met and fell in love with Lucy Mollin, who he would later marry in 1916. Rommel was commissioned as an officer in January 1912 and returned home to his local regiment. 2 years later, the First World War broke out. His wartime exploits turned the young Rommel into an exceptional man of action who fought with great distinction. He was wounded and won the Iron Cross fighting against the French and the Pour le Mérite while on the Italian front. Between the wars, Rommel stayed in the small German army of 100,000 allowed by the Versailles Treaty and wrote a book called Infantry Attacks. The book was brought to the attention of Adolf Hitler, the German leader, and Rommel was appointed to the War Ministry. When World War II was declared, Rommel, now a Major General, was by Hitler's side throughout the invasion of Poland in September 1939, this time in charge of his bodyguards. In recognition of his services, Hitler gave Rommel command of the 7th Panzer Division, and he was back in the fight. France was invaded on the 10th of May 1940, and by the 12th, Rommel's division had reached the River Meuse, where they met tough French resistance. Rommel, leading from the front, got his men over the river under heavy fire. His division pushed on further across France and deep into enemy territory. Rommel wrote to his wife that the war had turned into a lightning tour of France. Remarkably, in 5 weeks, Rommel captured 97,000 men, 458 tanks and armoured cars, 4,000 trucks and several hundred guns, with a loss of only 682 men and 42 tanks. In January 1941, Rommel was promoted to Lieutenant General, and in February he was sent to North Africa in command of the Afrika Korps. It was here that Rommel would win the reputation as one of the greatest commanders of the 20th century. With immense flair and imagination, Rommel again led his troops to a series of outstanding victories against the British. The greatest of these triumphs was the capture of Tobruk in Libya in June 1942. Rommel was promoted to Field Marshal and won the nickname the Desert Fox. After Tobruk, Rommel continued to push eastwards and in July ran up against the British at El Alamein. There wasn't to be a quick victory here, however, and both sides fought each other to a stalemate. For Rommel, it was a strategic defeat. He could advance no further. The Desert Fox was exhausted and sick, and his army was depleted and short of tanks. Churchill now appointed British General Montgomery to command the 8th Army, known as the Desert Rats. In October 1942, while Rommel was on sick leave, Montgomery launched a successful attack at El Alamein and shattered the myth of the invincible Afrika Korps. Although Rommel rushed back, it was too late to avoid defeat. It later emerged that the British had been reading all of Rommel's coded messages to Berlin. They knew about his shortages in men, tanks and supplies, and had been sinking his supply ships with airstrikes. The Afrika Korps was doomed. Back home in Germany, Hitler gave Rommel command of the sea defences of Western France against the expected Allied invasion. Rommel massively improved the defences, but when the Allies invaded in June 1944, they were nowhere near finished and the Allied armies got ashore. It was the beginning of the end for Germany and Rommel. Implicated in the plot to kill Hitler in July 1944, Rommel was offered the choice of suicide with a guarantee that his family would be safe, or a show trial that would see his family persecuted. He chose poison and a hero's funeral. So ended the life and career of a truly great commander, a man beloved by his troops whose dangers he shared, and revered by his enemies.